So let's stick with Sean McAvoy, the coach that you interviewed. I thought it was so interesting. I mean, he worked with Justin Fields. He worked with Trey Lance. He really gave, I thought, pretty candid analysis of both. Yeah. And he also talked about Zach Wilson. Now, the way I interpreted it, I think he would rank it Trevor Lawrence, Justin Fields, Trey Lance, Zach Wilson, with the caveat, that's how it is now. Yes. It sounded like he felt Lance is going to end up at number one. It was interesting. He was so skeptical of Zach Wilson, although he might be a little biased because the one guy he didn't work.
Of course, of course. Yeah.
Yeah. So he was very persuasive about Trey Lance. It feels like you and Jack were sold, and I feel like I was maybe not sold, but brought far along. So why don't you make the case now for Trey Lance, now that you've talked to the Trey Lance expert of the world?
Yeah, I'll say this. So early on in your show, and if anybody remembers this, they'll remember that I said this. And they're like, okay, now all of a sudden you're pounding the table for Lance. I said that Trey Lance would be the biggest disaster if taken. And this was back when we had the 12th pick. Mm-hmm. And I still think that that's a big possibility. If Shanahan is not patient with this kid, it absolutely can be the case. But now that I know that we have the opportunity to keep Jimmy this year, giving him a chance to sit, I feel like he can also be Shanahan's most beautiful masterpiece he's ever painted. So although it can be a disaster, the way that we've completely moved up to three and put all of the chips on the table, he's actually the perfect pick. And I'll tell you why. So first of all, I'm going to go with physical tools. He's got ideal NFL size. He's got arm strength through the roof. He's mobile, and he throws probably better than all of these quarterbacks, and that's including Wilson, in my opinion, off a platform. One thing that and Justin's improving, I believe, but even though he's very mobile, that doesn't necessarily mean that you can throw on the run. And that was something that I felt he had to work on. And I am seeing the improvement, which is great to see, but Lance had that innate ability kind of built into him. When I go to the mental tools, he ran a pro-style offense. He came from under center. And the one thing that I really took away from Sean McAvoy's interview was he ran that offense top to bottom.
Yes.
They would give him the formation, but then they would basically say, they would say, you go up to the line. If you don't like the protection we gave you, you have autonomy to change that.
Yep.
You can look to the outside. You can see where the cornerbacks are positioned and what you think is coming, and you can give them route combinations.
Yes.
Like, these are things that really no quarterbacks in college football do it. And so even though he only played a year, which is one of the biggest knocks on him, what more could he have proven? He had a perfect season. It goes back to when a team is starting out hot in the NBA. Let's take the Warriors, for example, right? They start out hot, and the knock is, well, they're playing a bunch of teams under 500. Well, that may be true, but all you can do is beat who's in front of you. And that's what Trey Lance did. Not only did he beat who was in front of him, but he's the only quarterback in the last 20 years out of the FCS or Division I football to do it with no turnovers. So
that's right.
He did it as good as he could do it. Going back to college wasn't going to prove anything. He already did it the best way possible.
Yeah.
But for him, he had some mechanical issues, and they were able to iron those mechanical issues out. He had an issue where he would drop his head when he would go through his reads. That problem, from what I understand, is completely fixed. So an accuracy issue that you may point out is probably now gone. And then you look at the intangibles. He's got a chip on his shoulder because he was told that he can only be a safety or a linebacker in the Big Ten.
Yeah.
And the man visits children hospitals in the off time. Like, we talk about the Watson situation, and whether it's true or not that he's guilty, we don't know. But you want a guy that you're not going to ever have to worry about. And I'm not saying that Fields or Wilson or Mac Jones are guys that you're necessarily going to have to worry about, although Mac does have a DUI in his background. I have no concerns about Trey Lance and his character.
Yeah.
So that for me is why I would take Trey Lance.
Yeah. I think the one thing that really stood out, what you said, what Coach McAvoy said, was what he does before the snap. And he even said it like he's not like those other quarterbacks who just get to the line of scrimmage and then look at their coach for all the answers.
Yeah.
Like, Yeah, like Justin Fields, right?
Right. I mean, he kind of gave him a slight there without whether he realized it or not.
Other quarterbacks. Actually, it's what most college quarterbacks do. It's nothing really against Justin Fields in particular. No. It's how they do it. They get to the line of scrimmage. They let the defense declare whatever it's going to do. And then they stop and turn to the coach. You even saw the Niners do it when Chip Kelly was their head coach. And the coach decides, okay, they're going to do all right. Let's call this play.
Right.
Well, Trey Lance did that. Now, I'm sure the coverages and the fronts that, and the pressures that he saw weren't super exotic, and it's going to be different in the NFL. But still, sure. I mean, that's Justin Fields didn't do it. And the other thing that the impression I got, tell me if you got a different impression, was he was like, yeah, you know, Justin Fields better now. But Justin Fields been working his whole life at this. He's been going to mechanics people his whole life. It seemed like he was much more optimistic that Trey Lance could improve. That, like, you know, Fields has been working to improve forever. Trey Lance is just getting started, and it's remarkable how much he absorbs and basically absorbs so quickly.
He called him a savant. He said that when any of these coaches get him on a whiteboard, not only will he impress him, but he'll probably teach him something, which was kind of cool to hear.
Yeah.
The other thing that and I'm glad he said it, because we had a private conversation before, and I wasn't sure that this was going to come out, but he basically said that he was salivating at the chance that there was going to be a combine, because he wanted to see Trey Lance side by side with these guys throwing. And that way everybody could see the difference one right after the other, because he felt like that would prove that Lance was the guy. And the last thing that he said was he doesn't have a perfect comp for Lance, and B, he has the most upside out of anybody he's ever coached. That includes Deshaun Watson.
Wow.
That's a big deal.
He's huge. I mean, the kid is really big. Like, he's going to be able to run over people the way Josh Allen does and Cam Newton does. I think there's a lot of similarities between Trey Lance and Cam Newton, the more that I look. I mean, you can knock Trey Lance for his lack of experience. Same thing with Cam. Cam played 1 year at Auburn. He also had a year at JUCO. That's the difference. That's basically the whole difference between them, is a year at JUCO. Right. Now, Cam played in the SEC. He won the national championship. Trey Lance won the national championship. Who's to say what Trey Lance would have done if he had been at Auburn? You know, he's pretty good. So, also, they ran about as much as they threw. You could look at Cam Newton coming out of Auburn and be like, man, I mean, really only about 300 throws, 300 runs. What kind of player are you? Well, he was pretty good until he got a little bit older. I don't know if Trey Lance – I think that the exciting thing about Trey Lance is people feel he has the ability to actually become a full-fledged pocket passer, not just Cam Newton.
Yeah, I think he's a better – if you just look at him side-by-side as prospects, I think the two knocks that were on Cam Newton, and one of them certainly was fair, which was his acumen. When you got him up on a whiteboard on ESPN in front of John Gruden, he kind of failed. And it wasn't his fault, but it was because Auburn just didn't prep him for that. That's not the way that it worked there. Well, we know that Trey Lance in that situation is not going to fail.
Yeah.
And the other thing is, just as an overall thrower, I think Trey Lance is more polished than Cam was at that time.
All right. Waruna says, thoughts on Jerry Rice's strong message to Fields. I missed it. Did you see it?
Yeah, I did see it. You know, I don't necessarily think that means that he prefers Fields. I think that he's just reaching out to a kid that deserves to be reached out to. I mean, Fields is definitely getting dumped on by a lot of people in the national media. And quite frankly, I think it's unfair. I mean, he was the consensus number two quarterback all the way up until the Northwestern game. And although I would take Lance ahead of him, I have Fields right there. I would not be upset if we took Fields, but I think that he's just reaching out to a young kid that is being slighted right now. And he kind of takes kindly to that because he was slighted in the same way. He was told that he was too slow and he couldn't do this and he couldn't do that. And so when he sees it happen, he just wants to give a good, strong message to it. And by the way, there is a possibility that Fields is the quarterback for the 49ers. And so why not extend that olive branch early?
Good point. I also thought McAvoy had an interesting point about Fields. Mm-hmm. No, about Wilson. I think he felt that he didn't really like Wilson. What do you think his take was on Wilson? That he basically said, like, look, people are knocking Fields for, like, they say one or two bad games. Mm-hmm. Wilson had, like, one or two bad years.
Yeah.
You know?
Yep.
Yeah. Who was he before this year?
Right. I think when he said that he was kind of salivating at the chance to see these guys throw side by side, I think he didn't say it, but I had a feeling that he was talking directly about Zach Wilson.
Interesting. All right, last question real quick. We'll get back on topic. Every move from now on is a smokescreen. Draft picks. Jimmy got a year in draft quarterback in the second round. I'm glad I've gotten so many people on this train with me. Yeah, absolutely. If they did that, I would give Kyle Shanahan an A++++, and I would personally extend his contract for another 8 years.